Okay, I'm back. Let's see if we can make some progress here. Would be nice, but don't let that stuff get to you. So let's just log in. We have a 10:11 currently. Let's assert MAVCTS 10:11 order to allow unless that. Let's have a look. See if we can get rid of some of this stuff here. So, for example, if you look at, this is a mislabeled file. So we're going to ignore this for now because this is mislabeled. Let's have a look at abort and see what we can do here. What we can add and not and cannot add. So let's go, we copied this over, let's go to our TE file, find ABRT and let's just paste this in below. I'll make a few comments here though, like that. Paste. Let's see what we can have and what we can't have. So for example, this one, these two require type, actually I'll just do it like this, type ABRT ETCT, this can be allowed, and the ABRT for cache can also be allowed. So those are the two. These two cannot be, well, the first one could be allowed, but we're just going to skip that for now. And this file, this is cannot be allowed. Password file T can be allowed. Password file. We're just going to take the ones that we're most sure of. And here we have dbus, system dbus dvarnt can be allowed. System dbus dvarnt. This is really, this is some basic stuff for stuff that needs to connect to the system bus type, and we don't need to require that type because we already have it. And that this one can also be allowed. It's basically just searching the user home door, and we know it needs to search it. So this, is okay. That's for a board applet. So let's see what AdSpy. AdSpy. Let's just copy it over and just a lot of this stuff cannot be allowed. Most of it, actually. Where is AdSpy? And I mean, Christ. I'll just do it like that so that I can basically search easier. Make some comments here and then inside that paste that. So we already require the password file. User home dir, we can do that, but we'll add a get attribute. Not sure, but that's probably a good idea. And that's basically all we can allow for AdSpy. The other stuff with relation to temp files and stuff, we need to take care of properly. So AdSpy back. We have Canberra. Just copy it over. Find Canberra. And just... Oh, I'm getting a message. This cannot be allowed. We need to take care of that. Now these three null signals can be done in a single line. Sending null signals all over the place. But they can be allowed. Then we have it's string connecting to pulse audio, which can be allowed. We might need to require process signal, so we'll require class process signal. And if we didn't have to do that, then we'll remove that later. The password file can be allowed. This can be probably be allowed, just file IP. Not sure why it needs to do that. These cannot be allowed currently, but this one can. So type tempfst. Type tempfst. This is basically just getting attributes of tempfst. Your random device, I think we already included that, so that can and that can be allowed, and it somehow is inheriting that. So that's also the nice thing of basically using raw policy. You can basically exactly see what gets inherited and what not. So I'm just keep it all nice and compact. Okay. Canberra, so that's Canberra. Now we have this stuff here, and I'm going to do that the ugly way. Dbus, where are you? On top. So this is going to be a very large block of policy. And I could make that simply one line by just And actually, I'm going to remove this for now. This. Because there's not much left. Alright, so I stopped with Fuzi. So from Fuzi, default of 4 months. This is all getting state of the user processes. Though we need to be careful. So I'll need to double check that. Double check it. I'll just do it like that so that I can see exactly what's going on. It's just reading state of all the processes that it owns. And I don't want to make it too coarse. I would just want to allow it the processes that it needs access to and not just any process. And it makes the policy big, I know, but it makes it also more tight. And although it might not actually have much security benefit, still, I prefer this, because I want to make it least privileged where possible. So, we allowed that. Let's go back and see what else it needs. What is, for example, this stuff. Damn, KPN is sending out spam. KPN is spamming its customers again. Dbus etct. Dbus etct can be allowed. Default context T. Default context T can be allowed. Devlog T, yep, can be allowed. I'll put that on a new line. And kernel Unix datagram socket sent to also type devlog T and kernel T. But I think I already had kernel T, but this can be allowed. Now let's see what we're missing from requires, because we're missing a bunch of requires. Unknown type, systemd, varlibd, systemdbusd. Where is system dbus dt varlib t varlib t, and then just add a require. Just going through all this stuff, making sure that it builds, because I'm unknown class file system Canberra. Where is Canberra? And we have an unknown class file system. Class file system get attribute. Right? Oh, actually. Damn. I was looking for Canberra. Canberra. Oh, and that's actually, that's why it's. Class file system get attribute. Now it builds. All right, so now we can go back and proceed. So we were at dbus, system dbus. That we had all that stuff, and then there's some remaining stuff hidden somewhere here. Let's just do this. Dbus, that's just top on top somewhere. Yeah. So let's just add this. Yeah. Password file can be allowed. Security, let's just require security. And actually that's already required probably, but we need class security t, class security t, actually security, and then compute av, compute av, we need that for dbus, and then we need a netlink. Class, and then that. And then it's actually seemingly process SQL. Class process SQL. Seemingly checking for exec. So I'm going to remove this for now because I'm actually suspecting that it's not just checking for exec but actually executing it. As for the datagram socket, I'm not sure, but okay, let's just ignore that for now. Dbus launch. Oh, and it also wants to search, and this two, these two, we forgot these two. Your random device reading it inherited though, and this is can also have a get attribute. It might not need it, but this okay. This I'll allow. This is just searching the user home door. Yeah. Let's just Go ahead. Dbus launch wants to search Dbus for lib D. Where is Dbus launch? It's probably not far away. Oops. All right. And then we have some deconf stuff. Let's just copy it over. Find deconf. Just run that there. It wants to get attribute of file stem system, so we need to basically require class type FST, and the file system we already have required. Home routine get attribute. I'm going to remove this for now, but I know it's needed. Proxy, that's okay, and all the remaining stuff needs to go. Let's just require proxy. No, actually, we don't need to require that. All right, move along. Dejadub, and here Dejadub is actually executing something, so we need to be careful there. So let's just skip that. DNSSEC mon. We are at DNSSEC mon here, so we can basically do this. Paste. And we need to require some stuff here. Require. So we're requiring a class TCP socket name connect. And we will require type DNSSEC port T. Font, that seems properly labeled, so also require types fonts cache t and fonts t. That can be allowed as well. FST, we already have that. Near this one we remove, but we know it needs it. Password file t can be allowed. We need TCP socket create connects. Class TCP socket create connect. We might already have that required, but just in case. We have dbusd varlib t, and we have tempfs, and we can remove that for now. This one is actually opening the urandom device, and this can be removed. This has to be removed because we don't know yet. So this might be just it for now. Let's go back. Let's go back. Evo address stuff. Let's just copy it over first. There won't be much remaining. Evo address factory. Where is Evo address? It's here. Let's just add this here. Let's see what we got. We won't do this yet. We can allow, we should allow this. This can be also be allowed. This cannot be allowed to remainders. So this is basically all we have. Let's go back. Evo alarm. Evo alarm T. Where is Evo alarm? Alarm. Not that one either. This one. Evo alarm. And just put that in there and see what we can and cannot use. And it's pretty simple. All this user home key stuff we cannot do yet, because all that stuff needs to be labeled first. P Evo Cal Factory. Where is Evo Cal? It's there. These cannot be allowed, although the get attribute should be eventually be allowed, and this can be removed. And I actually, what I forgot, but I'll do this here, require the netlink route socket class netlink route socket, and then these permissions. Close that. That's it for Evo Cal Factory. Not much. Back. Evo Source Registry. That's only one line actually. Copy. Where is Evo Source Reg? Not that one, not that one, this one. So it's just a single line here. Okay, let's go back onto the next, and we have some stuff there. And this is fuser mount. Where is fuser mount? And let's just add that here. Paste that in and let's see what we have to require here. We have to require some stuff. Require. First, we'll probably have to require the Fuzzy device. Fuzzy device T type. And we might not. We have to require the car file. But we also need to require Fuzzy FST. Fuzzy FST. We need to require a capability here. Capability DAC override. And that's a class. And this can be removed. This is that user temp there. This is actually the period DVFS. There, I think. File system mount, class file system mount, actually. Class file system mounts. And that should probably be close or enough. Gconf. Copy. Gconf D2. Where is Gconf D2? Gconf D2 is here. So let's add that here. Let's require type Gconf DETCT. Type Gconf ETCT. Let's close this for now. The password file is already required, and we have the system debug stuff, which is also already required. And as for the user home dir, we can actually allow search and get attribute. Get attribute and search. And that should be it for now. All right, back. Deacon source provider or something like that. Deacon search. Where is Deacon search? It's here. Let's see what we can add for this one. We can't do this. These two, we won't do them. And this is stuff that we can't do either. So this basically just ends with reading a password file. And the doc executes bin. So we can't really do that right now. Actually, exec man, memory stuff. And also, it's not actually executing gdoc. Oh yeah, it's actually executing that with a domain transition. So we will deal with this later. Soon as I see something executing something, then I basically stop and think, and I need to investigate. Okay. Let's go, and this is GNOME keyring daemon GKRD. Let's see what we have here, and it already had a bunch of rules here, and I'm actually not quite comfortable with this, but still, I went a little bit ahead of myself here. Sock file, right, get attribute, password file, sync socket connect to, and the other stuff cannot be allowed. This one is a little bit questionable. DOID. Where is DOAD? Not that one, not that one, this one. And paste that in. Let's see what we can do here. Devlog, yep, that's right. Homebrew T, we'll do that later, although that's kernel T, Kerberos. Let's just require Kerberos, require type krb5conft, and not 4 but 5. We have Unix datagram socket, and we have some user home content stuff that we need to take care of. Okay, back. TSD printer wants to stream connect, or stream connect, connect to the system bus. TSD printer. Where is TSD printer? Not that one, not that one, this one. TSD printer. Connecting to the system bus, probably for the printer. I guess, or for cups, probably. I guess. Session, that's a lot of stuff right there. Does it execute anything except shell? Shell's fine. No, it's not executing anything except shell. So this is session. Where is the session? Would be nice if this would be found, but it doesn't. Sucks. Now I'm going to take it the hard way. Here it is. It's quicker than doing the search function. Paste that in. And let's look it up, what we have and what we can allow, what we can't allow. this will take care of that later. Here it's basically, and we already have that required password file. Okay, I'll just remove this for now, but I'm not sure what it's doing there. This needs to be required. Require, and it's type systemd login sessionsd. This is actually a process state file, and we need also systemd unit file t, and I'm wondering which unit file that is, but doesn't really matter. Close this for now. I'll just keep it nice and compact, and then we have some user home stuff. It should be actually searching get attributes should be allowed, and all other stuff not at this point. And dum 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 dum. Use tempty, and then we have some XDM temp stuff. Type XDM temp t stuff that I'm going to allow. It's basically that sock in for this it temp, and then X authority or some of these, some of that stuff. I looked it up earlier, so. I looked it up earlier, and I confirmed that it's right. Data converts. Oops. Damn. Data convert. Gset data convert. Gset data convert. Then add that in. So we have fst file system get attribute, that's fine. Gconf reading that file is fine. This will be removed. It's actually also connecting to, I forgot that, to dbus. Password file t reading that is fine, and all this stuff except search and get attribute for user home dot t. Search get attributes and all the remaining stuff can be removed because we need to take a closer look at that. Alright, on to the next. Gsets, does it execute something? Doesn't seem to be. Lot of stuff here. Okay, so this is gset the GNOME settings daemon, and it doesn't seem to be executing anything, so that means that we can go ahead. Okay, gset the, where is gset the? Not that one. Oh, not this shit again. Here it is. We're going to do that here. Paste that in. And this can be removed. And let's just go ahead and require some stuff. For example, cupsd type cupsdt, not subsdt, cupsdt. And also cupsd var run t, that's legit. font t and font cache t is also legit. Fst is already done. User home will G, we're skipping that for now. Hardware data is also done. These are also done. These shell, here we have some signals that we can basically put in one line. All these daemons that use, or all these programs that use Pulse Audio need to send null signals to Pulse Audio. Stream connecting there. Proc RPM var live D, let's require that. Type RPM var live D, it's just searching for whatever reason. But that's legit. Here we have a class that we need to probably require. Class. K objects. We have a signal to self. We have sysfs here. So we'll just require sys. Oh, that's already required. We have dbus. And we have a type that I haven't seen before. Let's just require that type. Login these sessions, I think we haven't required that one either. Or actually we have. This is state info. This we have. Login D warranty, but this we need. Temp sock file with a generic type. No, don't want. UDEF, we need to basically do that. Type UDEF foreign to integrate there. Your random device, you already have that. It can search and get attribute of user home doors, but nothing else yet. And this should be removed. This should all be removed. So this might actually get us closer if it builds on to the next shell. That's a whole but shell's actually executing stuff. Need to take a closer look. G shell kel daemon, basically only the first two. So G shell kel D. And we can just paste these two in. And we'll just add a get attribute for this one. Because I'm doing that all over the place, so why not here? Back. G photo vol monitor. Oh, actually we're forgetting something. Fuzzy. GVFSD Fuzzy. Where is GVFSD Fuzzy? And not that one, not that one, this one. And also not that one, not that one, not that one, not that one. I'll add this here, and it's not much. We need Fuzzy device we already required, and the POSIX file we also already required, so we can get on with that. GVSD, GPhoto Volman. Was it? Yeah. GPhoto. Nice. It gave me a break. I think we already have this Netlink object U event socket. We might Yeah, we probably have all this stuff ready. There's a lot of noise in the background. DVSD, and it's only this one should be allowed. Where is GVFSDT? Not that one, not that one, this one. It's just a single rule. UDiskMon. And where is UDiskMon? So in a T, it's reading state, password file T, that K object sockets, and this should all be allowed already. I am set the, jeez, well, a lot. Copy. No. I am set the, where? I am setting daemon. I should just make this little bit more consistent, and then just add a comment here, fusuma. Oh, actually this is all fusuma. It's just this one here. Oh shit, it's executing a bin, so we need to skip this. It's executing something. If something is executing anything, then skip. So there are these two for Nout. Nout. We need to have a closer look at the stuff that's getting executed. Nautilus, let's allow it to at least get attribute and search user home doors. Network manager applet is also executing a bin. PA control is not executing, is it? Nope, it isn't, so we can do PA control. Copy. PA CTL. Add that in. Hopefully this will give us a little head start there. Homeroot, we are just skipping that for now. I don't know for what reason. So we have some signals here. So we'll just can do that in one line. Then we have a connect, a search, and then we have a generic temp file, and we don't endorse generic temp files. Tempfs get attribute, that's fine. Use a home door, yeah, he can search and get attribute, but that's all he can do for now. Search and get attribute, there's a lot of noise in the background. Someone is asking for attention. So that's PA control. Now pulse audio is a shitload of rules. Let's see if it actually executes anything. Doesn't seem to be executing anything, so that's fine. Let's copy this over. And let's search for pulse audio. And not that one. 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 But this one here, paste that in, and let's just walk through it. We need to require. We need to require a type, also etc, read write t. Type also etc RWT. Devlog sock is allowed. We'll skip the home root stuff for now for some stupid reason that I don't even realize. We have some capabilities that are some classes, and it's a process set scheduler, and it wants to send nil signals, but I think we already have that, and set resort limits. Oh, actually, make sure that it's not executing anything. I actually think that I guess not. It's not, I don't see it executing anything. Sound device T. This should be all done. Login sessions, login environment T. I think I already have that. For just to be sure. Add that. Unit file we have. Temp. Nope. Yes. Foreign T. Yes. Use home.t search and get attribute. That's fine, but nothing else. Search. Get attribute. Because I know Pulse Audio has business in the home directory. I just want to make sure that the stuff is labeled correctly first. Let's see. Okay, on to the next. SE applet. Password file, tempfs. Okay, let's just copy this over. And SE apple. Just paste that in. So we have password file T, we have debug stuff T, we have this file tempfs file, and we're not going to allow that. So I don't know why SE applet wants to search user home address, but I guess just allow that. Okay. And then we have here some stuff that we need to take care of. Basically the login user is still executing binaries. And binaries that we, that's basically ID and some other stuff, but some stuff that we want to prevent. TPMC, copy. Where is TPMC? TPMC, let's have a quick look at the chat, because Belgian guy, I'm just going to leave that to the big boys, so to speak. TPMC. Sometimes I can't be there to help. Temp read, not yet. Dev random, that's fine. Use home to search and get attribute is fine, but nothing more. This can be removed, the remainder. Right, back. Next. Minor. Does it execute anything? Doesn't seem to be executing. Tracker minor effects, so we can lose that. Copy. TR minor effects. At that. Paste that in. Let's see what we have. Cache. We can't do that right now. File system, that can. A password file is fine. Process set chat is also fine. SSH home, that lets us skip that for now. Sys control fs t. Not sure if that's required. Use home there. It can search and get attribute, but nothing else. And this stuff can all be removed for now. Go back. Tracker store. Does it execute anything? Doesn't seem to be executing anything, so then we can use that. Where is TR store? That's here. Let's just do this like that. Just to be sure. And then see what we can remove. We need to remove this stuff. We need to remove that stuff. And then we have a FIFO file read, that's fine. Random temp dir, we can't do that yet. Use home dot te, you can search and get attribute. Damn! The activity. And we leave the remainder. Okay, VDA agent. VDA agent. Where is VDA agent? Here it is. We need to require VDA agent warranty. Require type VDA agent. Foreign D, foreign T, and also type vert IO device T. Okay, let's move on. Here we have some stuff that's most of it I'm going to wait for later, but it's basically creating some stupid dirs. Control A. So this is XDG UD. So you there. XDG you there. Where is XDG you there? This for now. FST, that's fine, that should be fine. And then we have XRDB, which wants to execute a binary file. I'll just leave that for now. And then I'll just add this to the pulse audio section. Where is pulse audio? Oh no. Fine. Here is pulse audio. Paste that in a separate line and then just require this type. This actually shouldn't be in this module if all was well, but all isn't well. Paste. And let's see. Now let's just fix the missing requires, because there are missing requires. Obviously. So we have. What do we have? Permission get attributes sock file. Add. Keyring daemon. So get attribute on sock file, num keyring daemon. So dkrd, and then it has a get attribute on sock file. So I'll just add it here. It doesn't really matter where it's at, it's all one module. Next. Permission get attribute is not. Oh yeah. No. Get attribute is not defined for class sock file. I did that. The hell? Permission get attribute is not defined for class sock file. Line 351. So let's go there. Let's remove it here. And I'm 351. So where am I now? So let's go down a little. 351. So that's weird. It's actually require class sock file get attribute. Oh, that's because I didn't save it probably. Yeah. Unknown type systemd unit file at 953. Where is systemd unit file T? And that's a typo. Unknown type syscontrol fst at line 1680. Syscontrol fst require the type. Require type syscontrol fst. Jesus, what a noise. We have a permission get attribute for dir on line 2263. Note get attribute on dir. Oh, this typo. Where is note? Where is note? Where is note? And then there's a typo get attributes. So that's debugging. And it runs and it builds. Alright, so let's just install this. And then log out, and then I'll stop this episode. And then we'll proceed in the next one. We're steadily progressing though. before I'll do that, it's now 11:16, so I'll, yeah, 11:16, yes. And then kill all. You, my Lohan user. And then I'll search MAVC TS 1116 audit to allow less. Basically, this is stuff that in the next episode we're going to take care of, because this is stuff that happens on when you shut down. We also need to do that. Basically, we see it, the Fuser mount wants to unmount and stuff like that. So I'll just leave this here, and then we'll in start of next episode we'll just start there. Okay, let's quit.